Now let us discuss about a very interesting topic, which is a burning topic right now, is about the quorum sensing. Quorum sensing more especially in bacteria or microorganisms. So what do we mean by quorum sensing? Quorum sensing is a technique of communicating with each other. Okay, normally what we do in case of these higher organisms like us, we communicate with each other via different signaling, via different kinds of words, because we learn to talk, we know how to talk with each other. So we normally talk to each other via different processes, and we use different signs, different facial expressions to communicate our verbal accents from one to another. But what do bacteria gonna do? Because they are really small creatures, they are very small, they are very tiny, and they do not develop those organs to communicate with each other. They do not develop organs to talk with each other. So their talking system must be different than us. So we can say this, their talking thing is totally different than us. But what is actually that? We don't know that. And for many years this question is remained unanswered. But now in last couple of years, especially last 10 years or 15 years or so, we are scientists developing some very important techniques. The techniques help us to distinguish between the communication scheme which is existed between us and between the bacterial and between the bacterial cells with each other. So this kind of communication are totally based on chemical communication system, because they are really small objects, and all they have are different types of chemicals. So they use chemicals to communicate with each other. So this is in a whole is called the quorum sensing, or means the interaction between bacterial cells or interaction between microorganisms are called the quorum sensing via the chemical signaling. So this whole thing is based on the molecular level with the help of chemical signaling. Now let's move on to the next slide. Okay, here it is. So this is a very good picture. I just love this picture, that's why I'm giving it. I call it the living torch. Why I call it a living torch? Because you can see, this is a picture of squid, by the way. Squid, this is especially the Hawaiian squid. So this squid is found in Hawaii. And the squid, the interesting thing about this squid is that this squid have a few regions, a few sac in its the upper lobe here, which can glow at dark. As you can see, that in the dark ocean at night time, these regions glow. Why the squid needs to have a glowing region like that? Because some may say that it helps them to see what is happening, act like torch, but it is not like that. The actual thing about this glowing squid or glowing area of the squid is the basis of the quorum sensing. This is a very important example of quorum sensing, probably one of the most fascinating example of them all. And and why we call it the very good example of quorum sensing, I'm gonna tell you in a few moment. But actually what is happening in all the time, that you can see small droplets out there, the small tiny materials, and these tiny materials are the particles which is normally floating in the sea all the time. So why they are doing this? Because they are very small creatures. They are very small creatures. So let me change the color to demonstrate you that. They're very small creatures, and they stay usually in the daytime. They live in the coast of the sea. So they usually do not come out in the daytime. Why? Because as they are very small, they have a chance to be killed by different predators, because in the sea there are lots of different predators out there. But in the night time, they find a proper time to come out. But the problem remains the same, because in the night time there are different carnivores out there which can kill this kind of squid. So what they are doing in the night time is that they develop a technique, a very intelligent technique that can protect them against different predators. What is the technique? The technique is like that. In the night time, there is moon in the sky, and the moonlight come through from the moon towards the ocean level, As they live in a very shallow water, the moonlight can easily pass through the shallow water level and can illuminate them. And when the moonlight illuminates them, they finally form a shadow at the bench of the ocean. So they finally have a shadow of them. Okay. So as this moonlight develops shadow, different predators can distinguish them and they can kill them. So what they are doing here is they are producing light. And as they are producing this light helps them to counterattack of making this shadow. What does it mean is that there are different sensors in their back like that. This sensor helps them to detect the amount of moonlight that is encountered by its body. So it detects the amount of moonlight and it generates the intensity of light in such a way that these two different types of light from the moon and their own light helps them to illuminate in such a way that they cannot produce any shadow. And as a result of not producing any shadow, they eliminate the chance to be killed by the predators. Isn't it very, very intelligent technique? In fact, it is. And it is more fascinating because the glowing effect that they can create in their body is not created by themselves totally. It is created by a different set of bacterial colonies. Those bacteria are called Vibrio fischeri. Those bacteria are really, really very, very important bacteria to study quorum sensing, because those Vibrio fischeri colony that can be developed in their this type of sac can generate bioluminescence. And this bioluminescence what are generated by this Vibrio fischeri give them the proper illumination that helps them to eliminate their own shadow. Okay. So how those Vibrio fischeri degenerates those bioluminescence and why they generates those bioluminescence? To study that, we need to go through the detail about quorum sensing, the signaling between themselves. So what those bacteria are doing in those sacs of the squid, Hawaiian squid, is that. So suppose here we have a bacteria. So these are the bacteria. Suppose this is the bacteria. This is the Vibrio fischeri, for example. Suppose there is one bacteria present here and it produces some molecules. These molecules are responsible for talking with each other. For example, these are some molecules. These molecules, for example, the molecule A, this molecule is important for communicate with each other of bacteria. So why they are producing this concentration of molecules? Normally, this molecule is an inducer molecule for the illumination. So we call it the inducer illuminating molecules that can be secreted by a bacteria. So bacteria secretes an inducer of illuminescence molecule. So if this molecule re-enters the bacterial cell, there is a set of different proteins which can be activated, and that protein finally makes that illuminating protein, and finally the bacteria glows in the dark. That's the whole concept. But the bacterial colony needs to have a specific concentration of these illuminating molecules in the outside. Okay. For example, in this picture, I consider this picture number one, I consider this picture number two. In the picture number one, we have a very few bacteria. Thus, it produces very few molecules, the inducer molecules. And as a result of it, this molecule concentration is not enough to trigger the process of making illuminescence by the bacteria. So we need many more inducing molecules to finally generate the illuminating effect in the bacterial colonies. So let's now focus on the picture number two. In the picture number two, where you have the higher density of bacterial cell, that means those bacterial cell can generate more and more inducing molecules. Okay. And when they generate these more and more inducing molecules, these small molecules, small green colored molecules, these molecules can re-enter the bacterial cell and finally trigger the bacterial cell to make the illuminating molecules, those luminescent molecules. And those molecules help those bacteria to glow in the dark. Okay, because we have to have a critical concentration of those inducer molecules. And as we are looking at in this picture is that they produce their own inducing molecules, and those molecules are acting on themselves. So that's why this kind of system is called auto-inducing system or auto-signaling system. Okay, so this kind of auto-signaling can be shown in all this type of bacteria, all this type of quorum sensing systems. So in all these cases, in the second picture, when there are huge density of cell, they can produce a huge concentration of these inducing molecules, and these inducing molecules finally induce the bacterial cell to produce the luminescent molecule, and they produce the luminescent molecule, and they are grown on the dark. Okay, so in the previous picture, what we are looking at here in the night time in this squid, they produces lots of those bacterial cells. So the bacterial cell bacterial cell can divide very very rapidly and can grow very rapidly. So they grow and divide very rapidly, and after few generations, when they produce optimum amount of bacterial cell to produce an amount of chemicals, amount of auto-inducing molecules, that auto-inducing molecules induce them to produce the illuminating molecules, right? So what happens in the daytime? That's a big question. What happens to the daytime? In the daytime, they do not need the light to glow. So at the daytime, the squid generates another process. They pump out most of the bacterial cell in the outsides. Most of the bacterial cells are pumped out at the daytime. So the load of bacterial cell is decreased at the daytime. Okay, so now for example, there are lots of bacteria, so therefore there are, for example, there are normally, usually at the night time, there are 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power 10 bacterias are there per mm, bacterias per milliliter are there, but in the daytime they pump most of the bacteria, so they end up with a very few bacterias at the daytime. And that's why they do not generate any glowing effect at the daytime. But what happens throughout the daytime, when they reside in the shadow at the daytime, shadow of the coast in the daytime, the few bacterial cells are starting to grow, and they grow and divide, and finally make the concentration really huge enough to produce the glowing effect, to produce those auto-inducers, to induced by those auto-inducers. So this is a totally auto-inducing system. So it's an autocrine system throughout this process, as we are looking at. So this is the basic behind the quorum sensing. So why this kind of system is going on? Bacterial cells want to check, is there the bacterial cell is alone or not? Because they do not want to be alone. All the time, bacterial cells want to be in a clusters, in a colonies. So when a bacterial cell is there, it wants to know whether it is alone or it is with its companions. So if it secretes the inducing molecules, and if it has a response, if it has the response of those inducing molecules on its own proteins to illuminate itself, then it can know that whether it is alone or not. For example, in the first picture, if the bacteria secretes these inducing molecules, these inducing molecules is not able to produce any kind of illuminating effect. That in this case, this bacteria know that it is a single bacteria, so and not single bacteria, no other companions are out there. Okay, because the bacterial cell needs companions to survive, because they need to communicate with each other to survive. Because as you know, nobody can live in isolation. So if we are isolated from our own community system and all this thing, we'll just get scattered. For example, I can give you a few simple example. If your mobile phone is snatched from you, and if you were told to not to be contacted via the mobile phone or internet, will be very very, our condition will be very very severe in this case, because this kind of techno syndromes can catch us. Okay, so this is a process, because communication is needed, and we need the community to live on, because we depend on each other for different aspects. Bacteria do so. So in this case, what happens in this case, again, there are lots of bacteria. So if the bacteria secretes the inducing molecule acts on them, and finally it generates the illuminescence, and they will know that they are not alone, they are surrounded by their companions, and they will be happy and all these things. So this is the basics of quorum sensing. So they want them to check whether they are alone or many. And what is the practical application of that is, in most of the cases, bacteria want to create diseases, to invade a host and then stay there for many time, and then it produces its material and feed from that host and finally kill those host. So in those cases, what we call those bacteria, the virulent bacteria, to develop such a virulence, they need to check whether they are alone or they are many. So a virulence can only be made when they present in a huge amount, not in a very small amount. So that's why